Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know, WADL TV 38. I'm your guest hostess for today, Alfreda Bowden. Steve Hood is away on vacation, and since he's gone, we're talking about women's health. We're here on the Detroit Medical Center's central campus here at Harper-Hutzel Women's Hospital. Our next guest is Dr. Patrice Harold. Dr. Harold, thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, you're welcome.
Well, I want to talk to you about fibroids. I mean, it just seems to be such a vast condition. It's affecting so many women. I remember the different procedures and recovery times for my girlfriend, Yashan, whose recovery was 2 weeks, while my sister, Dolores, her recovery was like 6 to 10 weeks. What should we look for if we're thinking that this could possibly affect us?
Well, fibroids are very, very common, especially in African-American women. Actually, 50% of African-American women have fibroids. We don't really do anything with fibroids until they start to bother the patient. Okay. So the patient's having symptoms that she can no longer deal with heavy bleeding, pain, pressure, then we recommend treatment. Obviously, different treatment options. Some are surgical, some are non-surgical. One procedure, uterine artery embolization, is actually done by the radiologist. We actually cut the blood supply off to the fibroids so they can shrink down. Patients are in the hospital overnight, they go home the next day, and go back to work in about 10 to 14 days.
Okay.
Another procedure called a myomectomy is when we actually remove the fibroids. And that's the procedure if women want to retain their fertility. That's the one that's recommended. Those can be done now robotically when a patient can go back to work in about 2 weeks. But the older fashioned way, when they actually have called a laparotomy, they need to be opened up and the fibroids removed. They're going to be usually off work for 6 to 8 weeks at that point.
Okay, so then that procedure that my sister had was probably a little bit more intense in terms of trying to do more of a hysterectomy or something close to it?
Right, or probably not a hysterectomy, but a myomectomy. Where it depends on how many fibroids she has also.
Okay.
So we actually remove each fibroid from the uterus, and then we close up each one of those spaces. So that takes a little bit longer to heal.
Wow.
But now with robotic surgery that we have here at the DMC,
yes.
Now they actually heal a lot faster. There's
okay.
less blood loss, and they can get back to work sooner also.
No, that's amazing. I mean, it just seems like, you know, as you age and things kind of change, you wonder, like, what's going on? So it's just very refreshing to hear that there's opportunities to really work through these things so that you can go back to your normal life. Now, what are the symptoms? I know you started to talk a little bit about them. Can you tell us more about them?
First of all, most fibroids are asymptomatic.
Okay.
Like I said, 50% of African-American women have them. But common symptoms are heavy bleeding,
okay.
bleeding in between cycles, pain and pressure. As the fibers get large, they compress on certain organs too, especially the bladder. Someone will have what we call urinary frequency, feeling they have to go to the bathroom all the time because that fiber is pressing on her bladder.
So now, who do you go to seek out assistance for fibroids?
Your gynecologist.
Okay.
That's the first point to go to. You go to the gynecologist, and we do a pelvic exam. We get ultrasounds. Sometimes MRIs to see how many you have, and then they'll consult with the patient to figure out what's the best treatment option for that patient.
Okay, so then that means that after you see your gynecologist, what do you do next? If you actually need a procedure done, who does that procedure?
The gynecologist.
Oh,
we're the
wow.
surgeons in that case, right. But sometimes we do refer, like I said, to radiology for the procedure, the uterine artery embolization. That's actually done by the radiologist.
Oh, right.
And they work with the gynecologist and if that's the appropriate procedure for that patient.
Okay. And then again, the recovery just depends on what kind of procedure that you needed to have.
Absolutely.
Well,
yes.
Thank you again so much, Dr. Harold, for joining us. I really appreciate all of the information that you shared today.
Thank you.
We will be right back.